हेलो गाइस, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड। आई एम विशाली किकान, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट KIIT ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस। सो दिस इज द लास्ट एपिसोड इन आर एंटीना डिजाइन एंड द सिमुलेशन कोर्स यूजिंग द तरंग सॉफ्टवेयर। आई होप यू ऑल हैव सीन ऑल ऑफ द प्रीवियस एपिसोड्स। इफ नॉट, इट इज हाईली रिकमेंडेड दैट यू गो बैक एंड वॉच द प्रीवियस वीडियोज वंस एंड देन कम टू दिस वीडियो। वी हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट द फीचर इंस्टॉलेशन एंड अबाउट द पोर्टल ऑफ द तरंग सॉफ्टवेयर, एंड आफ्टर दैट we have already talked about the simulation of various other antennas. If you have still not seen this playlist, you can go to the channel and there you can find out the playlist antenna design and the simulation, and there you can find all of the episodes. So first we are going to talk about the spiral antenna. In that we are going to talk about the structure, its designing, the current distribution and its various applications as well. We are going to talk about some special information about the spiral antenna as well. After that we are going to move towards the helical antenna, its structure, designing, its modes of operation, and of course at last we are going to discuss its applications as well. So first of all, spiral antenna. So we all are familiar with the dipole antenna. If not, you can go and watch the theory as well as simulation video on the dipole antenna. So the dipole antenna is looking like this. We have a source and now the feed lines are turned. So if I have two wire transmission line, so the two wire transmission line is turned at the angle of 90 degree. This is my dipole antenna. Now we can make the spiral antenna from the dipole antenna. In the 1954 year, the spiral antenna was discovered from the dipole antenna by turning its edges. So what happens here, I have the dipole antenna. What I can do, I can turn its edges. This is my other edge. I can turn this edge as well. And this is how I can form my spiral antenna, right? So the current is moving in this wire. Also, the current is moving in the lower wire as well. So when the current is moving in the dipole antenna, it is represented like this. We all are aware about the current distribution in the dipole antenna. And from the dipole antenna only, we have made the spiral antenna. What is the speciality about the spiral antenna? It is a high bandwidth antenna, which means its lower to the upper frequency ratio for the operation is around 30. So FH upon FL, or I can say bandwidth is equal to 30. Which means if I have the lower frequency at 1 gigahertz, my antenna can perfectly work upon the 30 gigahertz frequency as well. This is amazing, right? So this is the very good advantage of spiral antenna, and because of this, it is highly used in the military operations. So now I know the bandwidth. So it is 30. So now it is also called the ultra bandwidth device. Okay, so it is ultra bandwidth antenna. So now coming to the current distribution, we know the current distribution, the dipole antenna. So we can make the current distribution in the dipole antenna, which is turned into the form of spiral antenna. So now here we will be having current moving like this. Now coming to the polarization, it is circularly polarized. And the circular polarization is a very good advantage. Why? Because whenever I have circular polarization, I can use the antenna in the telemetry operation. It is used in missiles, it is used in other applications for the spacecrafts as well. So it can be used in the direction finding applications as well. So it has wide applications because of its circular polarization nature. And what about bandwidth? Because it is having a high bandwidth, it is having the bandwidth ratio equal to 30, which means the circular polarization remains as it is up to the 30 gigahertz if I am starting from 1 gigahertz, right? So the circular polarization will not change, the type of polarization will not change, the impedance will not change, okay? The radiation pattern also will not change, okay? So now coming to the intrinsic impedance is nearly equal to 200 ohm. Okay, so it can be easily matched with the transmission line. So this is also very good quality because the reflection losses will be minimized. Okay, coming to the designing, R is equal to R naught e raised to power alpha phi. So here R naught is the minimum radius. So what is R naught? This is my R naught. Okay, so this is my R naught, and I can find out alpha. Alpha is the ratio in which these circularly turned edges are increasing. So alpha is the amount in which these are increasing. So I can find out R at any point. We can find out radius at any point with the help of this formula. Okay, so we can find out FH and FL as well. So what is FH? FH is FH is C upon 4R and FL is C upon 2 pi R naught. R naught is the smallest radius, this R, or take it R dash. What is R dash? R dash is the radius of the circumference. So this is my R dash. Okay, from center up to the circumference. So I can find out the lowest frequency as well as the highest frequency of the operation. So actually this is my highest frequency and this is my lowest frequency of operation. Right. So now I can find out this for this type of antenna. This is actually log periodic spiral antenna. We can have Archimedean spiral antenna also. So in the log periodic spiral antenna, we have a structure like this. Log periodic structure, we all know. Okay. So we have a log periodic structure. This is my log periodic structure, let's suppose, and we are turning this log periodic structure in the form of spiral antenna. Now when I have a linear structure, this is my linear structure, I can turn this linear structure also in the form of spiral antenna. This would be my Archimedean spiral antenna. So I have already told you about the applications. The applications involve the missile applications, the aircraft, the direction finding applications, and the telemetry applications as well. So all of these makes the spiral antenna very useful, right? So now for the Archimedean type of antenna, FL and FH would be equal to C upon 2 pi R1 and C upon 2 pi R2. So I hope now you understood the spiral antenna. Coming to the helical antenna. The helical antenna is having the structure like this. We have a coaxial cable. This is the outer conductor. We are turning the outer conductor at the angle of 90 degree and this is my inner conductor. Okay, so the inner conductor is turned in the form of a spring. So this forms the helical antenna. So this is the spacing between the two turns, which is termed as S. We have, if we have n number of turns, this is the diameter, right? So we can find out the circumference. Circumference is the circumference of a single turn starting from there to here. So this is my circumference. I hope you understood the basic structure. So now coming to the designing, we can find out the directivity. The directivity is equal to 15 nsc square upon lambda cube. Now I hope you know n is the number of turns, s is the spacing, c is the circumference, lambda is the operational wavelength. R in is 140 c upon lambda, half power beam width is 52 c upon lambda under root n s upon lambda. First null beam width is having the similar formula. Instead of 52, I have 115 in the numerator. So first null beam width is actually greater than half power beam width. Okay, now coming to the modes of operation. We have two modes of operation. First is normal mode and then we have the axial mode. So this is my normal mode of operation and this is my axial mode of operation. So now this antenna is a very high frequency or ultra high frequency antenna. So now in the normal mode of operation, I have एन एस इज वेरी मच लेस देन लैम्डा, दिस इज माय फर्स्ट कंडीशन. एंड द सेकंड कंडीशन इज दैट द डी डायमीटर इज वेरी मच लेस देन लैम्डा. ओके, सो इन द एक्सियल मोड, इन द एक्सियल मोड वी हैव द फर्स्ट कंडीशन एज c इज इक्वल टू लैम्डा एंड द थर्टी सेकेंड कंडीशन इज दैट 13 डिग्री लेस देन अल्फा लेस देन 14 डिग्री. सो दिस इज माय सेकंड कंडीशन. सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड द कंडीशन. सो एन एस इज द टोटल लेंथ ऑफ द हेलिकल एंटीना. सो इफ एन एस इज वेरी मच लेस देन लैम्डा एंड आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू इट इज वर्किंग ऑन अ वेरी हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी, सो विच मीन्स दिस एंटीना इज वेरी स्मॉल. सो व्हेन दिस एंटीना इज वेरी स्मॉल इट इज वर्किंग इन द नॉर्मल मोड एंड द रेडिएशन पैटर्न विल बी लुकिंग लाइक दिस. So as the name suggests, the radiation pattern are normal. Okay, so this is how my radiation pattern would be looking like. In the axial mode, the radiation pattern will be looking like this. Okay, so we are going to talk about the normal mode of operation when we are going to simulate it in our software. So now coming to the application. So again, it is used in the telemetry of applications. It is also having the circular polarization. Okay, so due to which it is used in the telemetry operation, it is having its use in the astronomy application as well, and it is used in the military applications as well. So both of these antennas are very important antennas. I hope you understood each one of them, and if you have any doubt, you can put the doubt in the comment. So now we will move towards the simulation of these two antennas. Thank you so much. So now we are moving towards the practical part. So we are going to simulate the spiral antenna and the helical antenna. We are going to see the various results that we have already seen in the theory part. We are going to justify them with the help of the Tarang software. So I hope you all have seen the previous episodes. Right? So if you have still not watched the previous episode, I recommend you all to watch all of them first and then come to this video, because this is just the conclusion video and here we are just talking about the spiral antenna and the helical antenna. I have already made the spiral and the helical antenna. I am going to show you them. I hope you now you are very clear about their designing and their structure. Okay, so first of all, I am moving towards the spiral antenna. So this is how my spiral antenna is looking like. Okay, I have taken a dipole antenna and I have made its two edges circular in nature. So this is my Archimedean spiral antenna, right? So this is the 3D diagram. Okay, so you can see it in 3D way that how my spiral antenna is looking like. Okay, so you can see that at this point is just looking like a line, but here it is looking like a circular structure. Okay, so now we are going to observe various things. So this is the real part and the imaginary part of the impedance, and from the tweak simulation option we can see that if I am increasing the number of turns in the spiral antenna, how the impedance is varying. Okay, so it, as I have already told you, it is a broadband antenna or it is an ultra broadband antenna. It is having the operational frequency, highest frequency to the lowest frequency ratio as 30, which is very high. So if the lowest frequency of operation is 1 gigahertz, highest frequency of operation could be 30 gigahertz. So it is operational on a very wide range of frequencies. The radiation pattern and the impedance are not changing on a very wide range of frequency, and we can verify them with the help of the S parameter. We have a very straight line in the S parameter. Again, I am going to show you that how if I change the number of turns, so how my S parameter is going to change. You can see we have straight operational frequency. So here you can see we have the proper working condition of the spiral antenna. Okay, so now we are going to see its voltage, current and the charge distribution. Okay, so this is my voltage distribution. Let's see the voltage distribution. Here we have the maximum voltage and we will be having the minimum voltage at this point. Okay, so it is again acting like a dipolar antenna. So now coming to the next distribution, which is our charge distribution. Okay, so I hope you remember how the charge was distributed in the dipolar antenna. Now you can see if I change the dipolar antenna into the spiral antenna, how the charge is distributed. Now here I don't have the maxima charge, the red portion is not there, you can see it from this diagram. Now coming to the current distribution, you can see the maximum current is at the center region only, and we are getting the minimum current around at this region. This is the portion where I am getting the minimum current, right? So I hope you understood voltage, current and the charge distribution. Now coming to the radiation pattern. So this is how the radiation pattern will be looking like. You can see it is having a good half power beam width. Okay, so the directivity would be less, but you can see it is working on a very large range of frequencies. So I can say that this antenna is of utmost interest. Okay, it can be used in the missile application, defense application, as I have already told you. So now we can take the near field region also. So I can say that the near field region is from -60 to 60 I am taking, and I am taking 51 points only. Here also I am taking the region from -60 to 60, and here I will be taking from -40 to 40, and I can take around 20 points. So this is the region that I have formed, and now I am going to see the near field. Okay, so you can see the near field over here, so we can animate it as well. We can choose the play option and it will start playing the animations. Okay, so you can see this is how the animations are played. Now you can see. So we are waiting for the field contour to come. It will be taking some time. So yes, here we have the field contour. So you can see it here. Again, we can see it with the help of play option. Okay, so you can see this is how I am getting the circularly polarized radiations. I hope this thing is clear to you. So now coming to the flux lines. Okay, so you can see the flux lines also from here. So the flux line says that we have the maxima at the center and the minima at the outward portion. So again, you can go to the play option and you can also animate the flux lines, how they are moving or how they are changing, right? So this is how you can see the flux lines as well. You can see it. Okay, so this is how flux lines are changing. I hope the spiral antenna is clear. I hope all of the outputs are clear. Now we will move towards the helical antenna. Okay, so this is my helical antenna. So if I see this antenna from here, it is looking like a spring. But if I see this antenna from this side, okay, so let me change the... Okay, so you can see now it is looking like a circle. Okay, so this is how I can change the viewpoint of the helical antenna as well. So you can see now it is looking like a spring, and we can change its orientation as well. So we can see its voltage, current and the charge distribution. So I am opening all of them. So this is how the voltage distribution will be looking like, right? So this is how my charge distribution will be looking like. And this is how my current, sorry, this is the voltage distribution again. I am going to see the current distribution. So this is my current distribution, right? So we can see the radiation pattern as well. So I can click on the radiation pattern option. You can see the radiation pattern of the helical antenna. So this is the radiation pattern that we have, okay? So you can also verify it with the help of theory. I have already told you it in the theory part. You can go to the play option as well. Okay, so it will start playing, right? So after that, we can see the near field region as well. So you can give any area. Okay, so here I am giving any area of my interest. Okay, now I am going to see the near field. Okay, so this is the plane where my helical antenna is there, right? So I am going to the play option. You can animate the results as well, right? You can increase or decrease its size. You can animate all of the results. You can see the flux lines as well. So if the flux lines are not coming, you can change the dimensions in the near field region. So you can change the region, you can increase the region or decrease the region, then you can see the flux lines as well. So I hope all of these things are clear to you, and I hope now you will be trying to make much more antennas, and you will be trying to do the research in this field. So it is not coming because I have taken a very small region. I can increase the region. Okay, now I have increased the region. We will be seeing all of the results again. So near field and the flux lines we are going to see again. So this is how the near field is going to look like. I can go to the play option. Okay, so here you can see this is my helical antenna, right? I can see the various radiations in all of the 360 degree directions. Okay, so this is how I can animate the results. You can see the output radiations in the near field. We can also see the field line or the flux lines as well. So you can see these are my flux lines. It took more time because I have taken a larger region. Okay, we can see the field contour as well. So this is how my field cut planes, field contours would be looking like. So you can see again we have the circularly polarized wave coming out from this helical antenna. So here I am concluding my session. I hope you all have gained enough information about the antenna simulation and the designing. You can comment in the comment section if you want any other design. We can also come up with the new videos on the new designing of the new antennas as well. If you want any further detail about any of the antenna, the theory part, that also I can give. You can put all of these things in the comment section, and you can also suggest any improvement or any doubts that you are encountering or any other feedback that you have. Thank you so much. Please like, share and subscribe this video. Thank you so much once again.